For many of us, spirituality is just the quest to find essence or true meaning and to really just connect with a higher consciousness.
Welcome to the Bring Me To Life podcast.
Connecting with your spirituality is very important in this life. By becoming mindful of all of that, you can realize where you are and if that is leading you to where you want to go.
Listen to the little simple things, because it's those little simple things that are going to shift you vibrationally in such a way that will prepare you to become very intuitively minded and ready to step forward on the next part of your path.
I hope you can feel the love that's inside you, it's inside me that connects us.
Hi there. Welcome, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to the Bring Me To Life podcast. I'm super excited to be joining you today with a beautiful interview with Ms. Devereaux, who is a confidence coach dedicated to empowering women to enhance their lives and just give them the power of mindset and style and charisma. So Devereaux, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself and your personal journey?
Yes, thank you so much, and thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here. So I like to start this story going all the way back to high school. I was getting ready to graduate, and in my senior year, I took a tour at a fashion school in Los Angeles, California. I'm originally from Atlanta, so I went cross-country for a fun trip with my father, and I fell in love with fashion. I wanted to pursue it for my career, and after looking at FITM, Fashion Institute of Design and Merchandising, I was like, this is it. I know that this is my life calling. Well, what ended up happening, it's really funny, is that my parents said that fashion wasn't a quote-unquote real job. It wasn't a real career. And so what I ended up doing was pursuing a more what I would call traditional path. So I ended up going to college and got an MBA degree, my Master in Business Administration, a marketing concentration, worked in corporate, worked in marketing agencies. And there was one day I was working at a marketing agency and I just got to a point feeling like I was stuck. I was just very unhappy with who I was, the woman that I was. And there was a huge disconnect between the woman that I wanted to be, who was this charming, classy, elegant woman, and the woman I was at the time. And so I decided that enough was enough. It was like my breaking point moment. I really wanted to make a change. So I took the initiative and just embarked on a journey to give my life a makeover. I worked with coaches. I took courses. I invested time in reading and researching and applying what I was learning to my life. And I just completely transformed every area of my personal and professional life. And so what I've learned along the way is that a lot of these, what I call timeless life principles, are not obvious. It's not knowledge that you can easily assume. It's not falling from the sky, and you certainly won't be formally taught. So in order to really have that competitive advantage, to really upgrade and elevate and enrich your life, you have to be proactive in seeking out the information and knowledge. And I ended up starting my business initially as a blog to just share advice with women to really just increase and enhance who they are so that they could truly shine and enjoy elevating their life with elegance. And what I realized was that this was much more, there was a greater need for much more than just advice. And so all of my coaching programs and product and service offerings have really stemmed from the need in the marketplace. Women, they want to know how to feel and look and live a feminine and refined life. And so that's where I come in to show them the way.
Beautiful. That's so true. There's so many people out there that they want to shine, but they don't know how to get started. And most often I've found too, working with clients, is that they don't necessarily have the support system. So finding a coach like you who has basically lived what they're going through is a beautiful way to really find a way to make others shine, because you kind of offer this like support in showing them the path.
Absolutely. And you know what's so great about it is that, you know, for a lot of women that are on this journey or looking to start this journey of transformation, there's a sense of, wow, I really honor and respect what you've been through. And there's a level of relatability, right? Because I've really been in their shoes where they're at right now. So I've been there, done that, and overcome those challenges. And it's just really helpful for me to be able to have those honest conversations with women, because I've certainly faced and overcome every problem that they're currently facing now.
That's beautiful. I've checked out your YouTube. You said that you started out kind of as like a blog, and looks like you have a lot of really awesome content. I love your branding and your style. It's really cohesive and easy to watch and listen to. I really admire that about a YouTube channel, because sometimes they can just be all over the place. But I really enjoyed seeing you kind of have like this activity going on for February, and you caught my attention with the Je ne sais quoi. Can you tell me more about that?
Yes, absolutely. Well, thank you for the kind words. And actually, my journey to blogging started with just a website. And of course, I added an Instagram shortly after. And YouTube was probably the newest element of my blog and content strategy. But YouTube has been a huge game changer. It's such an amazing platform to really connect with women around the world. So it's been so fascinating and so interesting. You know, countries like Denmark and Germany, and lots of women in India and the UK, and I'm based in the United States. And so it's just so much fun to really see the power of how small the world really is connected through technology. So my February initiative, I'm running a campaign, Journey to JNSQ, as a preview into a really exciting project I've been working on for quite a few years now. My first book will be published and available on March 1st, and it is essentially a guidebook for women to unlock and unleash their feminine power. And so it's really about creating that level of je ne sais quoi, which quite honestly is just your essence of elegance. It's that captivating, compelling, alluring nature that you have within yourself and you apply to every area in your life, from your mindset to your wardrobe to your actions and interactions. So, you know, your audience here is probably the first to hear that I will be announcing the book next month. I have not publicly announced it yet. So if you could keep that secret.
Yay, that's awesome news. I'm really excited for you. That's beautiful.
Yes. So looking forward to really helping women to find their inner power and leverage just being authentic, living with power, passion, and purpose. It's such an amazing, transformative way to really embrace and enjoy each day that we live.
That's amazing. I love it so much. It's what I'm all about, is shining and shining on. And it seems like a very elegant version of that. And that's what we are trying to do also with our Bring Me to Life challenge. So I'm glad that you reached out and that we were able to connect, because what we're here at the Bring Me to Life Network is trying to do the Bring Me to Life challenge as well. And each day we give an inspirational topic for our community to kind of take action in their life. And in a way, it's kind of helping that as well. It's bringing that energy in so that they feel comfortable. We did a week where we went through our clothing, and then a week where we wrote down the things we were grateful for, and we set goals for ourselves. So these are all different ways. And again, if you are looking for a coach or someone to keep you accountable, it's a good time and a good way to do it. How you mentioned your book, and I want to hear more about that, but real quick, I want to tell our audience that they can find you. It's at The Modern Lady, correct? The Modern
Lady. Yes. So it's themodernlady.com and also on YouTube at The Modern Lady.
Beautiful. What inspired the Modern Lady as your presence name?
Well, my previous name, believe it or not, was actually The Prep Pursuit. And what I was trying to figure out with a name was something that really captured the full realm of everything that I do, because a lot of times when I share with women or when I'm networking and I just am briefly talking about the different areas that I inspire and empower, you know, people typically think it's just one thing, right? So, oh, great, you can help me with my wardrobe, or, oh, great, you can help me with my mindset. And it's everything. It's a lifestyle. So the Modern Lady, the name really refers to a woman struggling before she comes to me, unsure, living in self-doubt, living in fear. And after working with me, she definitely leaves as a modern lady. She is refined, elegant, graceful, and most importantly, confident.
I love that. I love that. And I love that, like, you, like, it is the modern version of a lady, because being a lady has been kind of defined as so many different things. But it seems like what you're all about is just finding that personal power and kind of that sweet spot that really helps a person shine and feel successful with their life.
It is a combination of the personal power, but always with an added element of gracefulness and elegance. So if I only have a few seconds to tell someone what I do, I'm always saying the sentence that I will help you to elevate your life with elegance. So how can you be tasteful, refined, graceful, feminine, poised, adding that flavor in with the modern aspect? You know, certainly a lot of traditional etiquette principles were initially established in the 1800s, and life was very different in the 1800s and even early 1900s. We don't have horse and carriage, but there's an evolution of how we can really add the essence and the foundation from a lot of those common courtesies to our life and to our lifestyle today. So that's how I help women to navigate how to do that effectively. And it's so empowering when you are treating people with decency, courtesy, respect, you take care of yourself, you have that level of self-care, you really just feel better overall. And it's those feelings, those thoughts, those emotions that are going to drive everything else in your life. So it's all very interconnected.
Yes, yes, I agree. So tell me a little bit more about your book. I know we're kind of getting the sneak preview of it, but I am curious, and I'm sure the audience is too. What can we expect in this book?
Yes, absolutely. So in Je ne sais quoi, what you will find is a chapter for every area of your life to really just hit the reset button. It is, in a sense, a manual for me to give you the guide of how to give your life a makeover. So we work through your mindset, your self-grooming, beauty routine, health and exercise, style and wardrobe, communication, every aspect of your life. And really the main focus is on you as a woman. It's not you as an employee or an entrepreneur. It's on you, the core woman in the mirror. And so my hope is really to inspire and empower women to focus on themselves, to take that time reading the book, following the actionable advice sections, and really implementing the strategies and recommendations to see a change rather than just absorbing the information but not applying it. And so, you know, focusing on you, giving yourself that gift, it's a very special treat, because what I've found is that a lot of women can get easily caught up in the hustle and bustle of life. It's very, very easy to, with your career, with your family, with your children, all the other social activities on your calendar, let yourself just become a lower priority on the list, right? And so what I hope happens is the experience of reading and enjoying Je ne sais quoi is to really learn how to make yourself a priority start implementing new habits and new strategies to create this lifestyle that you can be intentional in how you're living rather than being reactive or kind of just going through the motions. And it's very, very easy for women to get into that trap because so much of a family falls on our shoulders, you know? When your child forgets lunch or needs their homework that they left on the kitchen table, they're probably calling mom, right? And so you're juggling so much in your life, and je ne sais quoi is an opportunity to really take some time for you so that you can intentionally understand and know how to create the life that you want for yourself.
Beautiful. That sounds like an amazing book for everybody to read. And and you said March, when are you releasing it? When can people expect it?
Yes, it will be available early March. So pre-order sales will be available early March on the 1st. And officially it will be launched and available for sale on March 20th. But you can pre-order copies on the 1st, and there's some added bonuses when you pre-order. So definitely an exciting time to get your copy early.
Yes. So we've talked about the book. I know the viewers are going to check into this, but I also just want to give you some shout outs. You are a rather accomplished life coach and speaker. It looks like you've been featured in Cosmopolitan and Forbes and all of these really amazing places. What is some advice you can give people who are looking to other than just tap into their je ne sais quoi, to really just embrace their personal power and grace?
Yes, and that's so powerful to be able to do that effectively. It really starts with the level of self-love. Just being able to understand and appreciate who you are. It's very easy for women to apologize for flaws or to focus on what can be improved rather than leveraging their strengths. And it's about perspective, right? So I do a lot of research around gender studies. I certainly love reading about women's leadership, women in business. And what's been so phenomenal is that over the last 5 or 6 years, we've seen a tremendous amount of attention being placed on women in business and women's leadership, you know, with Sheryl Sandberg and Lean In and so many other women that have really been carrying the torch for this. And so it's about really understanding the dynamic of all of the different gifts and talents and interests and passions that you have. You're multifaceted, and you're certainly multi-passionate, multi-talented, and being able to leverage your strengths, right? So for me, from a business perspective, my background is in marketing. And that's literally what I have done for Fortune 500 companies, for small startups, for medium-sized businesses, for solopreneurs. And so I am my best client. From a branding perspective, it's something that's very near and dear to my heart. And so when people look at my website, or maybe they're attending a workshop that I'm hosting, or in my online program with my coaching program, and they're just so impressed with the look and feel of everything. It's very intentional, but that is certainly one of my strengths. And I've been leveraging that. So in different ways that you can leverage your talents, your interests, and your strengths, it's best to do that personally and professionally. And just focus on being authentic. You know, there are so many women that look to the media, television programming, movies, magazines, social media. They're comparing themselves to so many other people, when the best thing that you can do is to assume the throne in your life and be the best version of you possible. So instead of looking to others to emulate, decide who you want to be and really just step into that. You know, it's just so incredibly powerful when you're able to really own who you are and embrace that, because out of that level of awareness and self-love and self-appreciation, you'll certainly be exuding confidence. It's almost like you don't have to try to be confident, you just naturally will. And so that's when you know you're in your sweet spot, is when you really start to just embrace and really just enjoy life, being you and doing the things that make you happy.
Beautiful. And you really do have a very elegant website. If any of our listeners have some time, I highly suggest you check out themodernlady.com. You've got a beautiful combination of not only offerings from your services, but you also have some chic shopping options. You have ways to unlock your confidence. You have it very easily accessible to find all of your blogs and tips and tricks that you are just kind of giving out there for free. You're really putting yourself out there again and being authentic. And I love that about your brand. And you do have, I see, some master classes and things available. Is there anything you would like to shout out about them?
Absolutely. So the free masterclass is 5 Keys to Unlocking Your Feminine Power. And that is an hour session to give you just 5 takeaways, things that you can start implementing immediately to really start unlocking your version of your personal best, your feminine power. I also have a coaching program called The Secret to Chic, which is essentially me working with you, teaching you, showing you, giving you the roadmap to giving your life a makeover. But the difference is that I'm with you every step of the journey. So it's not just advice. It's not just Microsoft Word documents. I am with you every step of the way, helping you to give you that support and also that accountability. And that's usually, you know, the disconnect between the women that get the results and the women that don't. The accountability and the support are so instrumental in you being successful, because when you're trying to make a change, you're going down a path, it's a new adventure, it's uncharted territory. You really need the support. You need someone else there to help show you the way, because otherwise it's like the blind leading the blind. And so it's so incredibly powerful to work with an expert in any area that you need assistance in. And I love my community of women in the Secret to Chic program. One thing that's also really cool about it is that once you enroll in the program, you get lifetime access. And so whenever there are new resources, there are guest speakers, we have this online community that is just an amazing resource of like-minded women that are looking to level up and step into their elegance and gracefulness with power. I also have a free online community called the Modern Lady Society. And the society it's very different from the Secret to Chic program. So it's more of a free community where women can collaborate and communicate virtually around the world. But I'm not giving, I only do maybe 1 or 2 live sessions a month. So there's no training, but it's just like a message board or a virtual meeting of the minds, if you will. And so all of my valuable resources are in the Secret to Chic program by design, so that you can get the most from the expertise that I have and all the guest speakers that I bring into the community as well. So all of that is at themodernlady.com.
Wow, you really have a lot to offer, and I am so grateful that you have contacted us and reached out so that we could share you with the audience. If whoever is listening, I highly suggest you check this out. She's releasing her book again on March 20th is the official day, but we can pre-order March 1st.
Yes, that's right.
Amazing. Well, thank you so much. Is there anything else you'd like to share with our audience while I have you here today?
Well, the last thing I would say is that for anyone listening that feels like they're stuck in a rut, they're not in a place where they want to be, I would really want to encourage you to know that you don't have to stay where you are. There's always an option. There's always another alternative. And if you are wanting something better for yourself, just know that it's available to you, it's possible for you, and all you have to do is take that first step Don't worry about all of the transformation, all of the change. Just worry about taking one step at a time so that you can really step into the woman or man that you want to become.
I love that. What a wonderful way to end the podcast and discussion today. So thank you again so much, Devereaux, for being a part of today's podcast. I again want everyone to go check out themodernlady.com. And March 1st is coming quicker than you expect. You can place those orders and check her all out. So I hope you have a great rest of your day.
Thank you so much for having me. It was a pleasure.
My pleasure as well. So thank you everyone for tuning in, and stay awake and shine on always.
Thanks for shining on with us.